Hey guys, Corey coming at you again. Today I've got what is it, five little kind of small rooms inside of an office building here. I'm going to be using my brand new pads I got from Challenger, and I'm going to be using a splash of delimonene. I had a guy asked me what brand I use, so I've got two different brands I use, and I don't use them very often. Just I'm doing some white Berber today, and I feel like it could probably use a little bit of solvent, because one of them is really soiled. The others are not nearly that bad. Let me show you what's going on here. All right, start here in the back. Anyway, I got white Berber here. This is not one of the heavily soiled ones. This one has got decent amount of soil in the back. This one here probably is about the same. There's one coming up that's really, really dirty. This guy right here, get all this to look good again. It's gonna take some scrubbing for sure, getting this guy to look good again. And we got this one here, got a disc in it. It's not too bad. And I've got this one right here. All right, and I've got the new pads. I showed those guys yesterday, but we'll look at them again here today. These are the new pads made by Challenger. They're about double or triple thick. Maybe I'd say about triple thick. Anyway, they're 50% cotton, 50% polyester. ChallengerOP.com is where you can go. Looking forward to using it. It should extract like cotton and last like a synthetic. And this is what I'm boosting the strength with today here. And I believe Medina is made here in Texas, but basically it's just cold pressed orange oil. Nothing exciting about it. It's just a solvent, doesn't carry a pH or anything. If you use too much and you don't need it, you could leave a residue, and you wouldn't use orange oil on any type of tile or anything. You leave a residue on tile. Once you're great on wood, it'll leave a little sheen behind on the wood, make the wood look really good. But yeah, this is pure orange oil. What does it say here? Cold pressed. Won't focus. Won't do it. Cold pressed orange peel extract emulsifier, and it's miscible in water. Anyway, I've got another one that works. I mean, one orange oil is as good as the other. I've got another one made by Green Goblin. Works about the same. Anyway, I am going to start back here and spray one at a time, maybe two at a time here. I want to spray this guy here, get it ready to go. And this guy here, give a little more dwell time on this one. Then we'll clean them both, and we'll try out the brand new pads. All right, let's see how this is going to work. Every different carpet will clean different, especially the pads that you use. Sometimes you don't know, and I haven't cleaned with a pad this kind of. This slick in a long time, so see how this works. working really well. I don't know how well. Yeah, it looks like it's showing up pretty good on camera too, it looks like. So I'm really happy with it. We're gonna probably do two rooms with this guy. Let me move this around here a little bit. Dirtier up here than it is toward the back. Standard reason. Works absolutely perfect. Let's get set up over here and we will do that again. We'll be able to tell more over here on this one for sure, since it is really dirty. Bound to be able to see how good that's working. Yep, you can, luckily. All right, I'm going to finish the room out and we'll take a look at the pad here in a minute. All right, that is the pad right there. It held up really well, not damaged at all. You could do each side if you wanted. I'm going to put a different one on and change it out. This is where CD was at, so that shows you how much soil I took out with it, and it more than likely, you know, it bleeds all the way through. So yeah, but you can flip them over and use them both sides if you want. I just generally don't. I just replace them and then wash them. And it'll take at least two washes to get all that out of there. That's a lot of soil. Got this guy here done. And this room here. So now I'm going to pre-spray two more. I'm going to pre-spray this guy here. And then the one next to it. Right here. And this one here is the nasty one here. This one's going to be all kinds of trouble here. This might even need a pre-scrub ahead of time to make it fair. I have put the striped bonnet on it, the synthetic one, with a scrubbing stripe. So we're gonna scrub over this guy first before we clean it to get a little better result, because this one is, I don't wanna say uncleanable, but it's worn to the point that we're never gonna make this guy look like new. So we're just gonna see how far we can take it. Preconditioned a little bit there. So now we're gonna clean it. With a pad from Challenger to finish it out. Get it ready to go here. All right. sure we're still recording here. Looking at the right spot. All right, we'll leave it like that, I guess, for now. Very realistic expectation for that. But had I not pre-scrubbed it ahead of time, I wouldn't have been able to do that. So that is just about as difficult as you can get. It's white, it's Olefin Berber, and it is beat down flat. So you're not going to get much tougher of a cleaning situation to try to correct. And you're not going to get it corrected, but that's just a realistic expectation. We'll take a look at the pad here in a minute. All right, that is the towel come off the bottom of the machine on that one. And This is the one before, so this one actually had more soil in it. But that room and this room both were done with the second tile. So we've got two more to go. We're going to do it before and after on those other two. There's desk in the way and everything else, so you're not going to get to see the cleaning. So we'll just take a look at it as soon as I'm done. Not much to see here. All right, we'll be back though. All right, we're all done now. So let's take a quick look over everything here. This office here. This one here, not a huge much going on. This is the main one that I expected to have all the trouble with and did. It came out decent, considering. No, it came out decent. We're not going to get this guy to make it look like it. This never happened to it. Put this guy here. These ones back here are probably pretty close to being dry. This one here. And then this was the first area that I cleaned. So it's kind of cool out today. It's about 60 degrees. And this is what I cleaned with. I'm a dealer for Challenger. And they make the pads for it too. It's ChallengerOP.com. And that is the best sprayer I've ever used, bar none. That's the best sprayer. All right, guys, that does it for this job. I've got a repair to do coming up later. I don't know that I'll cover it or not. It just depends if it looks like something I want to cover. Repairs don't get the attention that the cleaning does. Anyway, there's a lot going on in the news, and it's all driving me absolutely crazy, so I should be making a lot more videos now just to stay out of the news and try to keep upbeat. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. God bless, and I'll see you on the next video. And there's always the other channel, CoreymuscleTV. That is my bodybuilding channel. There'll be a link below that'll take you to it.